I sure hope so. Now, y'all tell me, when I'm attempting to make conversation with you beautiful people on the Infinite Couch, and you're completely silent for the most part, should I be offended? Should I be literally mad? Or should I just accept that perhaps you're lurking? Perhaps you're touching yourself to the sound of my voice? Perhaps you're in bed? I don't know. I kind of go back and forth. I'm a very mercurial person, so sometimes I love talking in the chat. And sometimes I, sometimes I lurk like a heinous beast. So I don't have a... I'm not always the same way. So if there's cooked food here, the people who made it are probably pretty close by, I would imagine. Right? Maybe not. Maybe, well, there's two sleeping bags. And there's a rad stag. Oh, there's actually three. I was gonna say, maybe the rad stag and the mole rat killed and cooked themselves. But I don't know. I was trying to figure how that would be possible, and I couldn't figure it, so... Post just says, sleepy. So you're trying to tell me that I'm sitting here streaming on this ancient artifact floating through space, the Infinite Couch. All you people are literally just sprawled across the Infinite Couch, cuddling, snuggling each other. You're telling me that the Osho is some kind of snuggle stream? Is that what you're fucking trying to tell me? Here I am, Grandpa Whitey, going across the wasteland, trying to be kind and helpful to all he seeks and encounters. And y'all are just snuggled up, watching. Fucked up. It's fucked up. Night vision scope makes me feel like I'm on some fucking Splinter Cell mission. No one even wants to weigh in on the excellent stream title. Wicked Shipping is the most northeastern name for a company I could imagine. I was about to be like, yep, this area is gonna be Ghoul Central. Then I come across a ghoul. Awesome. I wonder if the devs are so devious that I wonder if you can loot a ghoul that will all, like, still rise up eventually. If that does that make sense? Like, I wonder if you could actually, if it's set up to where you could loot a body and then it gets up later on. Because that would be amazing and terrifying. Batum says, if you want people to notice you got to get out some skin. That's how some of the bigger channels do it, right? I don't even know what you mean. What do you mean people to notice me? Aren't you noticing me? And get out some skin, like you want to see. I couldn't really show my nips, because of Twitch terms of service. But I could show some chest hair, probably. If you guys are into that at all. Hold up here. I actually gotta use my mortar and pestle real quick before I hack the shit out of this terminal. So just give me a moment, if you would please. Do so. My apologies. If you're maybe enjoying some herbal refreshments there at home, you know, now's a good time to do so as well. Just gotta use my hands here real quick. Sabatum says that might get people to stop snuggling. You think that me showing skin would discourage people from snuggling? You got it wrong, man. Right, let's do rare. All right. Laws. All right, it's got to be that A. Bang.
There we go.
Choose personality mode for the unit. Let's make it a medical responder. And then we'll activate the Protectron. Alright, what does the medical responding Protectron do? Nice. At least he doesn't shoot at me. Now, am I overly reading into the science fiction references in this game? Or is this a reference to one of the greatest science fiction franchises of all time? Anyone confirm for me? Am I just crazy? I wonder if you all even know what I'm talking about. I knew it. Hey, this combat shotgun works really good. And the sight on it is perfect. I love this combat shotgun. Batum says, gotta watch out for the clamps. Yeah, none of y'all know what the reference I think it is. I was gonna say, am I about to find Ripley somewhere? But none of y'all are cool enough to be into the alien films. You know, that actually brings up a really... Yo, that brings up a really good... topic. Alright, this is about to offend people, but that's alright. It is. So, like, nerd culture has taken off in such a degree, right? That at this stage of the game in nerd culture, sorry, I'm packing up here real quick, and then we'll listen to this holotape. But nerd culture is such like a thing now that like people like it's really important to people that they seem to be into stuff. Like, oh, I'm into Star Wars. Oh, I'm into this. Oh, I'm into that. To the degree that I think to people it's become more important to be like, oh, I like Alien, or I like Star Wars, or I like anything nerdy, you know, just to be able to make that reference instead of actually liking it or seeing it, you know what I mean? So it's like, it's like, so someone will pretend like, oh man, I love like the film Alien, for instance, but then have never actually seen it. They just have like seen it referenced to in, you know, Alien Isolation, or another example would be like Star Wars. Like everyone, like it's cool to be into Star Wars to a degree that some, like, people take it to a level that they don't even, they just want to be into something that's popular, I guess is what I'm trying to say.
I thought they were kind of done for.
Blake, I want you to listen to me as a brother here. This whole deal with Eddie is wicked shiesty. I mean, what kind of business partner threatens to kill you if the deal doesn't go his way? We are in way over our heads, man. I can't see a way out of this. No way except shutting down and getting out of Dodge. Give me a chance to talk this out with you face to face. I just want both of us to get out of this.
Oh, some nefarious dealings here at Wicked Shipping. Yam says, I'm tired of you putting me down based on my book and film proclivities, so I'm going to bed. Yo, man, did I call it or what? Did I call it or what? But to me, it's weird. Don't feel like you have to be into stuff. Like, it's okay to be like, nah, I've never seen that, you know? Or I've never heard of that. No one's gonna think you're less cool if you haven't seen or read or heard of something.
Nice.
Fucking Radstorm, dude. Take my radiation vitamins. Don't open that dog meat, there's radiation out there. Yam goes, none of you all are cool enough to have seen the movie Alien, quote Deva. That's exactly verbatim what I said. Good quoting. Man, that trailer key had the greatest keychain of all time on it. Here we go. Do you think that that's a tiny bottle of Nuka-Cola Quantum? that you could like pop that off and drink it down in an emergency if you needed some real quick.
Hell yeah.
I will admit it, though, riling up people on the internet is probably way too fun. I'm not sure why I would be interested in any of those deliveries, but I guess it updated my map with them, so that's good. It's mad important. Duct tape. I'm gonna write a sweet Fallout 4 mod. I'm gonna add a merchant. He's just going to be named the Tape Man, and he's going to sell all the different types of tape in the game, and I'm even going to mod him like a special suit of armor that's made out of duct tape. Then he'll just roam, and if you're lucky, you'll encounter the Tape Man, and he'll be able to tape you up. Excuse me? Oh. Is that how it's gonna be? Yeah, I'm a pretty big fan of this 32 round combat shotgun. Combat shotgun with the drum magazine. Very, very nice. I heard the Protrectron walking around, I was like, what the fuck? We're good to go though. Damn, I'm finding all the good ammo types up in here. I'm glad I came over here. Here's looking at you, bud. Oh, look at its teeth. Nasty, wrinkly, fucking prune face. I gotta be real, man. This ghoul looks a lot like Yoda. Does this not look like Yoda gone to the dark side? I feel like that really does look a lot like Yoda. There's some that's the other mod I'm making. I'm gonna make it so that feral ghouls or ghouls have pointy Yoda ears. And they'll actually attack you with lightsabers. But they won't attack the tape man. Alright, I'm not gonna have them attack my tape man merchant. I got a mod in. Robo says Yoda from Star Trek? Yeah. From the original series. I'm so suspicious of traps through here. Like, this whole time I felt like I should have already disarmed, or not disarmed, set off a trap by now. My normal trap checking method involves throwing explosives everywhere, but I haven't been doing that. I'm getting soft. I'm sitting here thinking, oh, there's probably no traps. There's traps, alright. Well, I think that's the whole wicked shipping facility squared away. Every environment in this game looks so good, even just like a fucking podunk ass trailer yard looks like incredible. I can't wait for like graphical mods for Fallout 4. I mean, I'm sure there's like a few out now, but I mean like solid ones, you know? Good ones. If you are just joining us, by the way, we're at the top of the fourth hour. Actually, we're at the top of the fifth. We've been streaming 4 hours. During this lovely Woden's Day edition of the Osho. In fact, the last Osho this week. I stream normally Sunday through Wednesday, 9 p.m. to 2 a.m. Pacific. Let's start at midnight if you're on the East Coast. Definitely appreciate y'all chilling, though, as usual. I do want to apologize to the Patreon subscribers. I'm going to be out of town this weekend, so I won't be able to do sub day. However, I do feel pretty bad, so I might be doing a bonus Osho either tomorrow or Friday. Just depends. Been having a great time catching up with Grandpa Whitey here this evening. Hopefully y'all have enjoyed chilling out and watching. Let's see what this little bit of water over here is. Batem says, can you open the red trailer? I remember checking, but let me double check. I don't think so. Yeah, as you can see, this trailer has botulism, you see, from the dent. So it's actually, this whole trailer is actually just filled with botulism, so I'm gonna avoid. I'll avoid that one. Big ups to everyone who has touched me in my follow area this evening. Definitely appreciate that. Y'all are new to the channel. I would encourage you to check out the info down below. You're on the website. You don't have to. But you might learn something beneficial. Might expand your mind or enlighten your soul a little bit. You never know. Alright, I'm gonna slowly, meticulously kick this tire all the way back to Sanctuary. Hope you're ready for the next 5 hours of the channel. Going on here? I guess the edges of the map are like highly radioactive. Okay. Someone was actually telling me that a little while back about how you can go out farther than the actual map and on your Pip-Boy, but you have to be like pretty well protected against radiation, and there's like shit even out there you can find. Pretty cool. Robo says pro slow running. Yeah, I don't think it's a secret that I'm the best, if not one of the best, slow runners in North America. But on a serious tip, like, why do people get tripped out? This is a good question. I'm all about having good questions, even though no one answers them but me. Why do people, in your opinion, trip out over, like, how someone is playing a game? Especially, like, if they're going slow, like, I guess, like, enjoying stuff, taking their time. It's like, it's a phenomenon I've never really experienced in real life. As far as, like, playing games with people. It's only something I've ever seen happen on Twitch, whether it's, like, when I'm streaming or, or, you know, especially when I watch other people's streams and I'm seeing their chat. And I wonder what it is. Is it that potentially... Could it be that the person is jealous of the person they're witnessing's ability to enjoy? You know, like maybe... They're upset that the person they're watching is getting more enjoyment out of the same thing they are, you know what I mean? So it'd be kind of like if you were eating a meal and you didn't think the meal tasted that good, so you're just kind of eating it like whatever. And you looked over and saw someone eating the same thing and they're like, oh my god, this is so dank. And you're kind of like, oh man, I wish mine was that good, or I, you know. That's my theory on it. I think it's like a jealousy thing. Jealousy of like seeing someone get so much joy out of it, you know?
Best scrap in the Commonwealth right here.
Oh, it's like a little watering hole. The trading post attached. What do you got? Whoops, I didn't want that wild corn. It's all good.
Excuse me.
I buy and sell. Just put up everything you got and let's see if we can make a deal.
Anything been happening around here?
If you don't mind, prefer to just talk shop for now. Got a lot of quality goods here.
He's got a nice setup up here in the hills.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
SRNXB says, maybe they're anticipatedly excited to see the streamer run into a thing. And come on, just go to the place, try the thing. You know, I do want to give that benefit of the doubt. I'm sure for some people it's like a positive thing. You're totally right. I guess it just worries me. Not even worries me. It makes me feel bad to see someone like suffer over something so silly. If that makes any sense. She said she had the best scrap in the Commonwealth, and that was definitely a fib. RoboDog says, people really into their games and want people to do it the right way. There is definitely some concern with playing games correctly out there, for sure. That's something I'll never understand as well. Alright, I don't want to steal from her. She's barely got anything to begin with. But it's cool that there's like a little trader shack up here. Does it even have a map marker? It totally doesn't. So if you go to this pond out here on the edge of the map, there's a trader that lives on the pond. But there's not even a map marker for it. You literally have to go to it. And then if you want to come back, you have to manually walk. You cannot go that way. My god! I was hoping that I would never run into one of these in Fallout 4. No. Why? No. Maybe if I push hard enough. She's a witch. She's got a force field. Wait a minute. That hang time. Hold up. Can we do anything fancy with this wall here? Hold up. What about Bethesda backwards jumping? Can I backwards jump? Hold up. Bethesda backwards jumping is a time-honored strategy. Can't we? Oh, I think it's actually the third-person animation that gives me that little bit of hang time that lets me get up there. I wanted to see if I could, like, get hella high up in the air. I don't think I can. Hold up. Man, I can Tony Hawk the shit out of this ridge, though. Tony Hawk. And Devin says, for me, there are times when I fear the streamer might miss something cool. They can only see if you approach from another direction, did something in a certain order, blah, blah, blah. That's the only time I get worried about how someone is playing something. Well, A, you should never worry about how someone's playing a video game, please. You got plenty of stress in your life already. That's definitely one thing you do not need to worry about, alright? You have my permission, my son, to not worry about that. But I definitely could see that point too. I guess my question is I guess I'm talking about more people that get like upset, you know, because there's like a mature way to be like, yo, there's this cool thing you might miss. Do you want me to tell you about it? And then the person can decide or whatever. It's a strange phenomenon. Because I've streamed on this here Twitch website a handful of times. And some of the reactions to like playing games slowly and like getting immersed and taking my time and like checking shit out have been like very surprising, to say the least. But like at the end of the day, when people act a fool in these ways I'm describing, I think it's just mostly because they need some love, you know? They just need a little bit of loving. And I'm happy to love them down, you know? They just need to sit on my infinite couch and I'll make a little bit of love to them. Alright, so this is another pipe revolver pistol, but instead of 15 points of AoE explosion damage, it does 10 points of cryo damage and freezes on critical hits. That's interesting. I'm not sure what killed this legendary mongrel, but I'll definitely take whatever it's got. Am I encumbered now? I would appear to be.
Hey, here.
So Bitem says, please don't make love to people on the couch. It kind of gets awkward. Listen, it's my infinite couch, alright? I'm gonna do whatever I want on it. I'll make love to whoever I want to on it. You know, despite how cool this seems, I actually much prefer my explode on impact legendary 45. Store the Molotov cocktails on the dog. That seems like a good idea. Dogs aren't known for running around bumping into stuff very often, are they? Good, I didn't really think they were. Yeah, I'm storing dog meat on dog meat. You can probably barely handle that level of, inception. You ever store dog meat on dog meat? I bet you haven't. But I have. Dog meat doesn't even mind. Batem says, are dirty waters stored in milk cartons? Yeah, you've never seen a carton of water? I'm actually just kind of fucking with you. I've never really seen a carton of water either. Outside of like an emergency response situation. Though that might be, you know, where it came from. I would imagine that in 200 years of time after a nuclear attack, that maybe some emergency management agencies might at least, you know, put some water out there or something. Maybe. Well, howdy. Gotta love this combat shotgun. Devin says, time to make a few more attempts at the old throne of the nuclear variety. Good luck, Devin. You'll need it. I would actually be very curious to play some sort of game, or even if it was just like something really minor, set in the days like right after the bombs drop in the Fallout universe. Those first like couple months. Oh, look at that fog setting in. Daruma says, what are you doing in game right now? Well, I'm exploring. Checking out the cool sun coming through the fog on this lake. What are you doing, Daruma? What are you up to? What are you doing in this stream right now? How many of y'all chilling on the infinite couch that are willing to type run around and just explore sometimes when you play games? Does anybody do that? Is it just a me thing? I love just fucking poking around, seeing what's out there. Enjoying, like, the sights, trying to find cool views and, hidden stuff. I love doing that in, like, every game that I play. But I could just be a freak. I'm prepared to accept that possibility. I guess a good way to sum up a lot of the things we've been talking about tonight, maybe, is that... Here we go. This is a quote you can take to the bank with you, okay? This is one you might want to get tatted, okay? Some people look at games to be... They're as tasks to be completed, okay? As like a job you gotta do. And some people look at games as an experience to be had. That kind of sums up a lot of the shit we've been talking about. Where'd that Super Mutant slip off to, though? Where'd he go? Come on, he's not that small. He couldn't have, like, juked me. Though it seems that is exactly what he did. Juked by a super mutant. Well, I mean, it's... Don't start no shit, won't be no shit, right? can head the other way. Fun. Here's some battling. That's another like touch that I really love in Fallout 4 are the when you can hear like distant gunfire. Well, night vision. Not the A1. Here they shoot. Oop. Alright. They're not friends. I wanted to see who they were shooting at. Trying to figure out all sides of this here conflict. What's going on over here? Boy, this fog's messing me up here. Look at that. Come on, fog, lift so I can get this shot. This is hilarious. The rumor says, depends on what type of game it is. Some games I play once and never touch again. Yo, but how does that relate to the question I asked at all? I was talking about when in the games that you play, do you go around and explore, or do you just go from, like, you know, objective to objective to objective? Obviously, if you play a game one time and put it down, yeah, you're probably not going to be exploring in that game. Seems like you may not like it at that point, so yes. I do kind of doubt you would go around and explore. Is that the only Raider scum up there? Huh? Who goes there? Probably way too much caution to be exercising if it's just raiders, but I don't know that it's just raiders up in there. Bust out the old shotgun, see who's home.
Get some, motherfucker!
Rise and shine, son of a bitch! Well, that's a hell of a way to wake up. Could you imagine, dude, you're this raider living out in this cabin with your raider girlfriend? You guys are getting fucking turnt day in and day out, robbing people, living the life. The one day, you think you hear something going on upstairs, but you're so faded, you don't care. So you go back to sleep. Then you hear something again, you start to wake up, and a grandpa busts in the door with a combat shotgun and blasts you to death. That is the way to go. That combat shotgun. Ugh. The glory. I think I'll just keep on exploring the vicinity here till the end of the stream for the next half hour or so. I think I've pretty much looted the vicinity of Drumlin Diner pretty well. Take a quick look. Got here. Interesting. Convenient. Got a concrete bunker here. With an iBot. Well, what do we got going on here? This is just like a... Looks like a military bunker with an iBot and... What's that? Yeah, it's got the flag. I'll be damned. Why can't I turn this into my own personal house? Grandpa would fully live in this. Alright. Voila. Open her up. Yep. That's that. Hello there. These blood bugs, they look really big, but if you've ever been to Minnesota, where the state bird is actually a mosquito, blood bugs aren't actually that big. In fact, they're about the actual size of Minnesota mosquitoes, for those of you who've never been. Most Minnesotans actually carry 45 caliber pistols on them at all times, in case mosquitoes get interested in them. Just as a precaution. I wish there was an easier way to tell friend from foe. I mean, that's I'm part of the immersion, but... Well, these guys aren't shooting at me. Are we cool? Nope. Not cool. Alright, I got it. We're not cool. Fun. I get it. Okay, that car is gonna explode. Let's get away from that. Oh my god! Easy. Guess I got the answer I was looking for, whether or not those guys were nice. They blew up a car over there, holy fuck. Let's take care of that fucking machine gun turret. I gotta get out of the habit of taking cover behind cars, because they, are not the most stable things. Wait, did that car explosion take them out? They killed themselves. Scrubs. Fucking killed themselves. Via exploding car. Well done, boys. Well done. Do we have more?
Someone there.
Okay. Super mutants down below. Okay. It's about to get a little more interesting, I believe.
What? Who's there? Who's there?
Are these bad guys too? Alright. I'm hidden from the super mutants. About here. I think they're bad. They seem bad. Are the super mutants gonna fight him? Yep, they are. This ought to be interesting. He tossed the Molotov and hit his buddy. Well done. That was top notch. Man, you're a pro with those Molotovs. Oh, don't fucking shoot at me, little dildo. Easy. Easy. No! I was talking too much shit. He turned around and killed me. God damn it. Every time I talk shit to NPCs in a game, I get instantaneous karma. Literally every time. Without fail. It was interesting how that shot to the dome, with my four cranked musket did zero damage to the gunner. Maybe their heads are completely energy resistant. That's gotta be what it is, right? See how that did a little bit of damage. Okay. Oh god. Are they, I guess they're wrecking me because my armor doesn't have like any energy resistance, does it? I guess I just gotta get farther off and try to fight them that way. I'll let them get into the shit with the super mutants, and I'll just clean up afterward. That's the strat. There we go.
Next time, fight better.
Just gotta use my brain a little bit, you know? Now I can just slip by here. Nothing. Do not worry, super mutants. I will not harm you. I am a friend.
Stupid noises.
Right.
That sound, what is it?
It's destiny. Yo. Oop, I still have mines equipped. I go. I still have mines equipped, and then it immediately. And literally, before the words were even out of my mouth all the way, literally explodes.
Someone there.
Wow. That was a beautiful moment. Man, I'm starving. I can't wait to eat after this stream.
No fight today.
I dominated a big ass bowl of edamame pasta and turkey meatballs before the stream, but I probably should have had two or three bowls. I'll know better next time.
Hello? Someone there? What? Who's there?
Think you're cool, do ya? Don't hit my puppy with your board, you motherfucker. Alright, where's your little piece of shit super mutant friend, huh? Did I get all of you? Huh? Where did you go? I wanna fight too. Where's your fucking friend that I killed?
I can smell you out there.
Did that super mutant just scream, yeah, from beyond the grave? That's brilliant. Alright, I think that was the last one, so now to try to find the ones I killed over here. I don't know how far back they were up in here is the thing. I guess maybe I vaporized one of them into like a pile of ash, but I can't find them. That little encounter was tricky. He's sleeping. I'm not sure about exactly how that encounter went down though, because like, alright, so those dudes are called gunners and they seem to be another gang of like raiders, but they have energy weapons, and I guess that thing on the freeway was their outpost. Like, were the super mutants just coming through the area at the same time? Or were the super mutants living under the bridge down here and the gunners had no idea? That seems pretty unlikely. I guess the super mutants were just out here on a, you know, raid, seeing what's up. And, we all just happened to run into each other at the same time. Drumus asked probably a minute ago, can dog meat blow your cover? I don't think so. I don't think dog meat affects whether or not you're detected.
Hey, over here.
Dog meat's like, fine, I'll teleport. Whatever gets you there, dog meat. The puppy is full. Ooh, that looks like it might be even more well defended. Now the night vision's coming in handy. During the day, the night vision scope is terrible. I wonder if there's a way to toggle on the night vision-itude. Alright, all I see is automated defenses. And this symbol, I'm not sure what that symbol means. But I bet I can take out that machine gun turret pretty easily. Did you see that? Did you see that? Dog meat, don't fall off the freeway. Did you see that? Did you see it? These boards collapsed. They were solid and they collapsed. Since when does that happen? That was awesome. I know that's a minor thing to get hype about, but that was fucking cool. And I love that dog meat just falls off over and over. Robo says I missed it. Well, you can pull up the VOD right now and see it if you knew how to use Twitch, but these boards just collapsed. Like, they were solid and I walked over them, then I like backed over them and they started to collapse through, and I would have fallen through myself if I hadn't like lucked out. It was fucking crazy. But in a good way, like, that attention to detail, though. Man, the more I play Fallout 4, the happier I get with it. I know it's kind of popular to not like this game, but I'm loving it, personally. What's good, Minoff? He says, what up again? Yo, you've made it just in time for the last 15 minutes of the O-Show, brother. Congrats. Coming in hot and heavy with that laser pistol. Better take some of Grandpa's medicine here. Oh, you know what? I forgot to cure myself of addiction, so it's a good thing that I'm doing the drugs I'm addicted to right now. Robo says, trap boards are just physics. I think it was a physics trap, actually. I think it was a trap using the physics of the game. Can I not hit that from here? Wonder if there's like some invisible wall shenanigans going on. My god, these birds are trapped! There we go. Got a hold of it that time. I gotta free these birds that are trapped. Birds, be free! Steak says, Dave, it's popular to not like things in general. I mean, I guess that's true. I guess it is. I think it's probably popular just to be negative in general. Not even just not liking stuff, just to be negative about everything. It's kind of a shame. But what are you gonna do? What is that off in the distance? That must be Grey Garden. Spooky. But I try to keep it pretty positive myself. I wouldn't even say that I try to keep it pretty positive. I just keep it real. And the reason I think that's relevant is I think, like, people will kind of like pick up the opinions that they find online, you know, so that they can sound knowledgeable in conversation. And the opinions you can find online tend to be quite negative. So it results in people tending to have a more negative opinion than they would if they had generated a genuine opinion on their own instead of just seeing what the internet is saying. Does that make any sense? Because if you think about it, in any kind of review type situation, whether it's like filling out a review for a product or a restaurant or even just talking on chat, the people that are going to like be willing to type up something or a review or, you know, express some detailed opinion tend to be the people that have something negative to say, whereas the people that are pleased tend to just not say anything at all. So you get this like negative bias that's not necessarily accurate or realistic, but it is definitely negative. So, like, in the case of Fallout 4, all the people that like Fallout 4 genuinely are probably playing it. Whereas the people that don't like it are on message boards or Steam reviews or whatever posting about it. What can I do in about 10 minutes here? Because I have been trying to stick to ending the stream at, like, 2. I may start starting earlier so I can go for longer because I always feel like 5 hours isn't enough for me, but I don't want to make it longer, because then I already get up pretty late, so I don't want to get up any later. So maybe I'll just continue to explore for about 10 here. So when do I get to craft the weapon that just lets me shoot fusion, like the cars themselves? I want a weapon that lets me put on my power armor and then launch cars. Like, I want to be able to aim like a gravity gun, pick up a car with the fusion core still intact, and then fling that motherfucker as a projectile. Where's that mod at? Excuse me, I gotta use my laser musket to kill a mutated bear. One moment. This is how you hunt for Yao Guai in the aftertimes. Don't forget your 45 caliber carbine looking thing that was once a pistol that shoots exploding bullets. That's key. Robo says DLC. My car chucker is DLC? God damn it. The monkey scared the piss out of me. Where I hear a bear, where's the bear? You hear that bear? Shit. There's the bear. Sorry, the Yaoguai. Totally not a bear. I wonder how the term Yaoguai even came to be. Am I still under the influence of my lovely battle drugs? Yes. Fail me now, combat shotgun. Oh, I love the combat shotgun. Holy shit. That was amazing. Thank you, combat shotgun. You're my best friend. That is for real my favorite weapon I found in the game so far now. I'm still a big fan of this right here, especially the way I've modded it out, because it's got the nice, exploding bullets. But even just this stock combat shotgun is a fucking pleasure to use. Steak says, in Mandarin, Yaoguai translates as monster or demon. Okay, but like, how did people in the northeastern region of the United States start calling mutated bears a Chinese word? That's what I'm asking. Why? I don't think that's ever explained. I mean, don't get me wrong, Fallout is my favorite, like, lore, like, my favorite franchise, universe, whatever you want to call it. Alright, don't get me wrong, but still doesn't always totally add up. Snake says they were named by the descendants of Chinese survivors living in internment camps. Well, let me try to understand that. So the bears that mutated in the 200 years after the bombs fell are named by Chinese survivors living in internment camps. And then I guess maybe they hopped on Fallout Facebook and posted so everyone would know. That must have been what happened. How far overweight am I here? I'm overweight even with the psycho buff. What am I carrying that's so heavy? I guess that fishing rod's pretty heavy. The Yao Guai hides are pretty heavy too. There we go. I think that will get me there. Nice. Robodog says it's all in the lore, Dave. Yeah, but are we allowed to talk about the lore and stuff, or do y'all prefer that we all just sit in smug silence, secure in the euphoria of our intelligence of knowing all the lore? Because like I like to like talk about it, you know, kind of fun. Speaking of fun, though. It's been swell, man, but swelling's gone down. That is gonna be the entire OSHA. It's the whole thing. You can't believe you ate the whole thing, but you did. As always, man, definitely appreciate y'all chilling on the Infinite Couch once again. But that will do it for this edition of the O Show. Now, there are a few orders of business to attend to here at the end of the broadcast. The first is, of course, to thank these illustrious members of the 420 Club. I'd like to thank Concat, Mia aka Steak, BeanChan99, Antique Cowboy, Sebatum, Sims Magic, Ninth Gate, Robodog, Axical, Smarms, Manic Volcanic, Dennis Cooley, Endeavin, Lego Hog, Gatsby, and Shibotech. Big ups to y'all. Much obliged. Now the final order of business here is always to take a look at the Twitch channels I have found. Try to recommend something chill to check out. I'm gonna recommend the homie Zombie Barricades again. He's streaming Diablo 3 again. I don't know what it is. There's something about him playing Diablo 3 that is... He's like the only person that has made Diablo 3 entertaining for me to watch, so take a look. And I'll host it up here as well, in case you want like a smaller
chat experience.
But that will do it until next time, which If I don't work in a bonus stream, the next one's not gonna be until Monday. But I might wind up streaming tomorrow or Friday, so we'll have to see. But definitely appreciate y'all chilling. I'll see you next time.